Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle, myself Tanmay.
In this video, we will look at one advanced coding question which was asked in TCS digital exam. Problem statement is quite big, I will just quickly glance through it. There is one amusement park in which there is a wetted maze challenge. This consists of a set of east-west roads, that is left-to-right roads, and north-south roads, that is up-down roads. Each intersection has a block of iron bar, the weight of which is given. So as we can see, the weighted maze challenge, it has some horizontal roads and it has some vertical roads, and at every intersection of these roads there will be some iron bar present which weight will be given. So all these intersections will have some iron bar. After that, you enter the maze at the top left corner with 1 kg in a cart. So you will enter the maze here, and the exit from the maze is at the bottom right corner. So you have the exit from the maze is here. Alright, movement at any intersection is to the right or down provided a road exists in that direction. So here we can say that from this particular point we can either move to right or we can move to down. Similarly, from this point we can either move to right or we can move to down. Okay, but from this last point in the first row we cannot move to right because there is no road present here, so we can only move down here. Now the condition that is given is, at each intersection you pass through, you must exchange the weight in your cart with the weight of the bar at intersection if it is heavier than the weight you have in the cart. Alright, so first of all we are entering the maze with 1 kg in a cart. In the next intersection of the roads, if the weight present in that intersection is suppose 10 kg, so you have to pick up that 10 kg and you will have now 10 kg in your cart. And naturally our objective is to determine a path through the maze along the road so that one can exit the maze with minimum weight in the cart. Alright, so let us look at input section. The first line consists of a positive integer n, which is number of intersection in any up down or left right road. The next n lines each consists of n positive integers representing the weights at the intersection in the corresponding left right road. So we will be given input in a matrix kind of format. Output is a positive integer that represents the minimum weight possible in the cart when exiting the maze. So we will have to print just one integer as output. Now this whole problem will be very clear once we look at the example. So let's take a look at example now. First number in sample input is 4, that is there will be 4 horizontal roads and 4 vertical roads. Below that there is 4x4 matrix which indicates the weight of the iron bar present at each intersection of the road. Keep in mind that we enter this matrix in this top left corner from this one element, and we have to exit this maze from bottom right corner at this position, that is 13, and we have to travel in such a way that we can either move to right of an intersection or we can move to downward of an intersection provided the road exists in that direction. And while traveling, if at any intersection the weight of the iron bar is greater than the weight that we currently have in our cart, then we have to exchange the weights. For example, we start our journey from this one, so we have initially 1 kg of weight in our cart. Suppose we travel to this next intersection which has weight 8, so as 8 is greater than 1, we will have to exchange the weight here, so now we will have 8 kg of weight in our cart. Suppose from 8 we travel to 21, then as 21 is greater than 8, so again we have to exchange the weight, so now we will have 21 in our cart. Suppose from this 21 we traveled below and we reached this intersection which has weight 10. Now we have weight 21 kg in our cart, and at intersection the weight is only 10 kg. Alright, so there is no need to exchange the weight at this position, so weight will remain as 21 here also. Now from this, if we traveled below, the weight at this intersection is 23. Now as 23 is greater than 21, we will again have to exchange the weight, so the weight in our cart will now become 23, so on and so forth. So I hope you have understood this condition. As we can see, output for this example is given as 22. So one of the path from which we can have 22 weight in our cart while exiting the maze is, suppose from 1 we travel to 8. So weight in our cart will now become 8. From 8 we travel to 17. So weight in our cart will now become 17. From 17 suppose we travel to 10. So weight in our cart will remain 17 here, as 10 is less than 17. So now from 10 we travel to suppose 20. Alright, so weight in the cart will now become 20. After this, from 20 we travel to 22. So weight in our cart will now become 22. And from 22 we travel to 13. Weight in our cart will remain as 22 because 13 is less than 22. So while exiting the maze, weight in our cart will be 22, and which will be the answer. Now notice here that this is not the only path. We can have another path. Suppose from example 1, from 1 we travel to 8, from 8 we travel to 21, then to 7, and then to bottomwards, from 7 to 20, then to 22, and then to 13. And there can be many such paths also. It is important to understand in this case that greedy approach is not going to work here. For example, if we are at 1, then we have two choices. We can either travel to this intersection which has weight 8, or we can travel to this intersection which has weight as 19. So if we decided that let's travel to 8 because this weight is less than 19, but after traveling to 8, if suppose weight to the right of 8 is suppose say 200 and weight to the bottom of 8 is also 200, alright, then if it was such situation, then it would have made sense to travel to 19 instead, and after 19 we would have traveled to 2, then 14, and so on and so forth up to 13. Alright, so making a local choice from this one is not going to work because we do not know about the further elements if we choose this path. So we have to come up with a better solution. One of the approach to solve this problem can be just travel through all the paths and then compare which path has the minimum weight in our cart. So for example, initially we can choose this particular path. In the next iteration, we can choose this particular path. In the similar way, we can have such many paths. So the total number of paths, the total number of possible paths is quite high. So obviously the issue in this case will be time complexity, as we will have to backtrack in every path. So obviously we will have to come up with the better solution to solve this problem. The better solution in this case is dynamic programming. Let us look at that approach now. Now what is asked from us in this problem is what minimum weight we can have while exiting the maze. But before that, let us limit our thinking in finding out what can be the minimum weight in our cart at this very first position itself, that is 1. I'm going to write down these values, that is the minimum weights that we can have in our cart at each and every position, in this separate matrix. I'm calling this as min weight matrix. So at very first position it will be of course 1 kg, because we are entering the maze with 1 kg in our cart. Now let us talk about this second intersection, which has iron bar of weight 8 kg. Now there is only one way we can reach up to this intersection, that is take right from this one. Alright, so now visiting this intersection we will have 1 kg in our cart, but the original weight at this intersection is 8 kg. So we will have to exchange the weight here. So the minimum weight at this position will become 8. Alright. Let's talk about this next position now, that is 21. Again, there is only one way we can reach up to this position, that is taking right from the previous intersection. Now we will have weight in our cart as 8 kg here, and the weight at intersection is 21 kg. As 21 is greater than 8, we will again have to exchange the weight in cart. So the weight, minimum weight we can have at this position is 21. And let us talk about this last position in first row now. Again, we can take right from 21. We will have weight as 21 kg in our cart, and original weight at this position is 7 kg. Note here that 7 is less than 21, so there is no need for us to exchange the weight in cart. So the minimum weight we can have at this particular position will remain as 21 itself. Alright. So now we have filled up this first row in minimum weight matrix. Let us fill this first column also. the minimum weight we can have at this particular position, that is 19. Let us talk about that. There is only one way we can visit 19, that is take downturn from this one. While visiting this intersection, we have to exchange the weight in our cart. So the weight, minimum weight here is 19. Now while visiting the next position, that is this 2, the minimum weight at this position will remain as 19. And while visiting this 14, the minimum weight will remain as 19 itself. Alright, so we have filled up first row now and first column also. Note here that all these values in minimum weight matrix are the minimum possible weight we can have at that particular position by obeying all the conditions given. So in the similar way, let us fill up rest of the elements in this minimum weight matrix also. So let us talk about this position, that is 17. We are going to fill this particular position in our minimum weight matrix. Now note here that there are two ways to reach up to this position, that is we can either take downward turn from this 8 or we can take right turn from this 19. Now out of these two paths, of course 8 is less than 19, so it makes sense to choose this downward path. So we will visit this particular position 17 with 8 kg of weight in our cart. But notice here that the original weight at this particular intersection is 17 kg. After reaching here, we will have to exchange the weights in our cart. So we will exchange the weight and the weight here will become 17. We will take a look at one more value, that is this particular position 10. We are talking about this value in our minimum weight matrix. Now again, there are two ways to reach up to this position, that is either take downward turn from this 21 or take right turn from this 17 now. Now again, choose the minimum between these two values, that is 21 and 17. Of course, 17 is less than 21. So we will reach this position with 17 kg of weight in our cart. And notice now the original weight present at this intersection is 10 kg only. Now as this 10 is less than 17, there is no need for us to exchange the weight in our cart. So the weight here at this position will remain at 17 only. In the similar way, we have to fill up all these elements in our minimum weight matrix. And quite obviously, whatever will be the value at this last position, that is in our matrix n by n, this value will be our answer, because this will be the minimum possible weight we can have in our cart while exiting the maze. So as we know, the answer here in this case is 22. So this is our final answer.
So to summarize this approach, let us say we have our original 4x4 matrix whose name is maze. Alright, so maze is our two-dimensional array, and the matrix that we derived now, let us call it as our minimum weight matrix. And to fill up this minimum weight matrix, the strategy that we are using is matrix of ij, that is I is the row and j is the column. So matrix ij is equal to maximum value between maze of ij and minimum between matrix of I minus 1 j and matrix of I j minus 1. So matrix of I minus 1 j and matrix of I j minus 1 are nothing but the adjacent elements of a particular position. Matrix of I minus 1 j means the number which is present upward of the current position, and matrix of ij minus 1 means number which is present to the left of the current position. So whatever will be the minimum of these two numbers, we have to compare that with the maze of ij, that is the original number present in the maze array, and whatever will be the maximum out of this current value, suppose say x, and this value, suppose say y, whatever will be the maximum between x and y, we have to assign that value to matrix of ij. Now suppose say we have to find the value of matrix 3-2. Now what position is this 3-2 means? That is third row and second column. So at this position we have to fill up in the matrix. So what will be the values according to our formula? We have to choose maximum between maze of ij. Now maze of ij in this case is 18. So we will write first value as 18, and minimum between matrix of I minus 1 j. This value is 17, so I will write minimum of 17 and matrix of I जे माइनस वन दैट इज 19. ओके सो नाउ मिनिमम बिटवीन 17 एंड 19 इज 17 ऑफ कोर्स. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज फाइंड द मैक्सिमम बिटवीन 18 एंड 17. नाउ दैट वैल्यू इज 18 ऑफ कोर्स, 18 इज ग्रेटर दैन 17. सो वी हैव टू असाइन 18 टू पोजिशन मैट्रिक्स 3 2. ऑल राइट सो दैट इज वाई वी हैव रिटन 18 हियर. So this is the one line formula we are using to assign values at particular position in this minimum weight matrix that we have derived here.
Here is the code for this problem. First of all, I am taking input for the variable n. N is number of horizontal and vertical rows. Then I am declaring one two-dimensional array which is named as maze and whose size is n rows and n columns. After that, I am taking input for each position in this maze matrix. Now, this is the main part of the solution. I am first declaring one minimum weight matrix who has size same as our maze, that is n by n. Then I am initializing the first position in this mean weight matrix as the value of maze 0 0. So this value will be 1 here because we are entering the maze with 1 kg in our cart. So that is why we are first initializing this first value in our minimum weight matrix. In this below loop, now we are filling the zeroth row of minimum weight matrix. So minimum weight matrix of 0j will be maximum between maze of 0j and minimum weight matrix of 0j minus 1. Below this loop, we are filling zeroth column of minimum weight matrix. So minimum weight matrix of i0 is going to be maximum value between maze of i0 and minimum weight matrix of i-1 0. After filling 0th row and 0th column, now we are going to fill all the remaining elements of minimum weight matrix. So formula for minimum weight matrix at position ith row and jth column is maximum between maze of ij and minimum between minimum weight of matrix i-1j and mean weight matrix ij-1. Alright, so whatever will be the maximum between maze of ij and the value of this particular function will be our value for minimum weight matrix ij. And once we do that, once we fill all the elements of minimum weight matrix, below that I am just printing the answer. The answer is going to be the value of last element in our minimum weight matrix, that is minimum weight matrix n-1 n-1. So this is the code for this question. The code might be little complicated to understand. I am giving the link to this code in the description of this video, so do check that out. Now let us try and run this program. So initially we have value of n as 4, that is we will have 4 horizontal rods and 4 vertical rods. The value of weight of iron bars at each intersection is as follows, that is 1, 8, 21, 7, then 19, 17, 10 and 20, then 2, 18, 23, 22 and 14, 25, 4 and 13. Alright, so if I run this program now, the output in this case is coming as 22. So we know this is the right answer. Let's take another example. Suppose say value of n is 5 now and value of weight of iron bar at each intersection is as follows. So these are all the values in our maze matrix. So if we run this input now, then the answer is coming as 38. Now one of the paths from which we can have this 31 weight is like this. So suppose from 1 we travel to 13, from 13 to 29, then to 15, then to 15 again, after that to 21, then to 31, then to 38 and finally to 24. So in that case, while exiting the matrix, we will have weight as 38 kgs in our cart. So I guess that's all for this question. Remember, this question was asked in TCS digital exam as advanced coding problem. We can say difficulty level of this problem as medium to hard. So even if you haven't understood some part of explanation, please ask in comment section below. And finally, if you have liked this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for the next videos.